When we hit rock bottom, if that makes sense, when we hit rock bottom, sometimes we ask ourselves where to turn and who to look for, and where can we find our joy at. But here it talks about, I called upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and sent me in a large place. When I see in the scripture, it literally reminded me on, I can't do none on my own. I can't really depend on nobody, and my peace and joy is found in the Lord. So if his peace is made perfect in me, the trials that I'm gonna go through won't really consume me. Hallelujah. Then verse 6 talks about the Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me? Well, it was a lot of trials that I was facing, and where I work at, people questioning me and people threatening me, just because of my personality. I don't know how I am. People say I'm weird, but I don't know how I am when it comes to myself. But all I know is I'm always trying to live this thing out, this Christian life. And whenever, I'll be smiling and joking around and just welcoming customers. By the way, I miss a lot of stuff. But man, what can man do unto me? I don't believe in fear. Even though fear, it's something that hinders a lot of people from doing a lot of stuff. I don't believe in fear because, I'm not given a spirit of fear. So I honor God with that. Hallelujah. And it goes forth talking about, the Lord taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desires upon them that hate me. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put your confidence in men. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put your confidence in princes.
Amen.
All nations compass me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them. See, when I read the scripture that all nations compass me about, but in the name of the Lord I will destroy them, it's like it gave me a visual in my head. It's like not physically beat them, but I'm just renouncing stuff that they say against me that's false. Yeah, so it's like, if they say things that's not lined up with the word of God concerning me, I destroy them by speaking life over it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Then verse 14, it talks about the Lord is my strength and song, and it's become my salvation. The Lord is my strength and song has become my salvation. I don't know why, though, it was last night that I got in the scriptures, but right when I landed on this, it's like I got real bold. I got real encouraged. I got real encouraged that, I'm more than a conqueror. I'm literally more than a conqueror, and he's become a salvation. And I believe salvation is deliverance.
Hallelujah.
You know, deliverance. I forgot the other two. But one of them is deliverance. I know that God is faithful and will deliver me from all trials if I call upon Him in Jesus' name. And I'm skipping verses, y'all. I'm just verse 17 talks about I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. And that's what I actually was praying. That's what I actually was praying. Just declaring that scripture over me while I was praying, because even though it's not a physical death, mentally it could drain me. The trials that I face at work mentally can drain me, can kill me. But I speak life that I will live in the midst of it, and I will continue to declare that the God is good. You know, and praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One of my favorites, talks about verse 21. I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me and art become my salvation. Wow. I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me and art become my salvation. I don't know why, whenever somebody says something it's like when somebody speaks death over me at work, I rejoice, but not in a rejoicing way, like I receive the discouragement, but it's because I found myself just with peace with God. So it's like, praise the Lord, hallelujah. Oh, you speak that against me? Hallelujah. And it's like, man, we just got to get to a place where we praise God, even though the circumstances, the trials can get big. It's like we gotta learn how to literally praise God in the midst of it, because that's where our joy and peace comes in. And hallelujah. The last one is, this is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous. It is marvelous in our eyes. That scripture literally lets me know that if God created, you know, heaven and earth, and He being new us is the foundation of the world, it's like we was created with a purpose. We was created with hallelujah, Father God. It's like we was created with a purpose. So it's like our life is already orchestrated in motion. It's like it's already in motion. Everything we do, it's like it's in motion. But that's only if we obey. Only if we obey, because even though all things work together for the good who love God. Praise the Lord. That's a powerful scripture. But I believe that it comes with obedience. You know, sometimes we go through life not realizing why we're going through some stuff. And sometimes we are ignorant of it. But God said, you know, it's gonna work out good for our good. So I just encourage y'all to continue declaring the word over yourself. Don't be ashamed to let your light so shine before men. Not for your glory, but for God's glory, so people can see what God is doing in your life. And just continue to rejoice and be glad that, you know, that God has, you know, has already spoken His word over you, and it shall come to pass.
Amen.
So, y'all, God bless y'all. In Jesus' name, that was just a word that I had last night talking to Brother Cola. And I just want to really encourage y'all. Stay blessed and stay real encouraged. In Jesus' name, thank y'all so much. And if y'all have any questions or if y'all have anything to say, you know, right now is the time, I believe. Anybody? Hallelujah, Father God. So praise God, praise the Lord. God bless. Right now, I'm about to welcome the man of God.
Y'all, let's give God a hand.
Praise the Lord. God bless.
Well, I don't want us to just brush over, because the stuff he's talking about is our joy. And you did a good job. Because